Then we'll talk about the kind of strategy. So the first strategy comes here is PO strategy. And what is PO strategy? When a strategy specifies one and the same particular action for each decision point in the game, that is generally known as the PO strategy. So if the strategy specifies, okay, whether it's about taking a decision on output, taking a decision on sales, taking a decision on maximizing profit, taking a decision on advertising, whatever the strategy, whatever the decision point, if the same particular action is going to follow or the strategy specifies the same particular action for each decision point, this is generally known as the PO strategy. Then we have a dominant and dominated strategy. Optimum strategy taken by a player which maximizes its outcome, whatever the strategy of its opponent. So, what is dominant strategy? The optimum strategy that is taken by the player which maximizes its outcome irrespective of whatever may be the strategy of the opponent. So, whatever the optimum strategy taken by one firm, keeping in the view whatever may be the strategy by the other firm, if that is giving the best outcome, that is generally known as the dominant strategy. So, we will just take an example to understand this dominant strategy. Suppose given all combination strategy of the other player, the outcome derived by a player from strategy A is better than strategy B. Generally, strategy A is the dominant strategy. So, given all possible combination of strategy of the other player, if the outcome by a player from strategy A is better than strategy B, in this case strategy A will be known as the dominant strategy and strategy B is the dominated strategy. Why strategy B is the dominated strategy? Because it is not the best looking at the whatever the strategy taken by the rivals or the whatever the strategy taken by the all possible strategy taken by the opponents. So, a dominant strategy equilibrium is one in which all the players have a dominant strategy. So, it is not about the Nash equilibrium, it is about the dominant strategy equilibrium, and dominant strategy equilibrium is one where all the players they have the at least one dominant strategy and through that we reach to the dominant strategy equilibrium. So, suppose one player is having a dominant strategy, other player is not having, we cannot get a dominant strategy equilibrium in that particular game. Then we have maximin strategy. Maximin strategy is the one which maximizes among the worst case payoff of the player, and maximin value for the game for a player is that minimum amount payoff guaranteed by the maximin strategy. So, maximin value of the game for a player, that is at least minimum the player is getting if they are playing this particular strategy. Then min max strategy, in which generally player minimize the best case pay of its rival. So, whatever the best case pay of the rivals, this particular player try to minimize this, and the minimax value of two players for player 1 is maximum amount of pay up that the other player could achieve under the player 1 of the minimax strategy. So, minimax value of two players for a player 1 is maximum amount of pay up what that can be achieved under the player minimax strategy. We'll understand all this strategy by just taking the example. We'll start with the dominant dominated strategy, max min min max strategy, and also we'll see whether we have a Nash equilibrium just taking this example. So there is two mobile service provider in the market. One is Firm 1, second one is Firm 2. They have their own advertising drive to enhance the market share. So both have two strategy options, either to advertise or not to advertise. So, two mobile service providers, one is Firm 1, another is Firm 2, they have their own advertising drive to enhance the market share. Both have two strategy option, either to advertise or not to advertise. Now, what would be the possible strategy combination? If both Firm 1 and Firm 2 advertise, Firm 1 get a market share of 50, Firm 2 get a market share of 20. So, if Firm 1 and Firm 2 both of them they are advertising, The outcome is he has to maximize the market share by advertising. So in this case, if both of them they are advertising, firm 1 get a market share of 50 and firm 2 get a market share of 20. If firm 1 advertises and firm 2 does not advertise, the firm 1 get a market share of 60 and firm 2 get a market share of 10. So when both of them they are advertising, firm A get 50, firm 2 gets 20. When firm 1 only advertises and firm 2 does not advertise, firm 1 get a market share of 60 and firm 2 get a market share of 10. If firm 1 is not advertising, firm 2 advertises, then firm 1 get a market share of 40, firm 2 get a market share of 30. If both firm 1 and firm 2 does not advertise, firm 1 get a market share of 55 and firm 2 get a market share of 25. Now, this is the payoff matrix on the basis of their strategy. Now, we will take this payoff matrix to understand whether what is their dominated strategy, what is their dominant strategy, what is the max min strategy, what is their min max strategy, and whether they are reaching the equilibrium or not, whether they are reaching the Nash equilibrium or not. Okay. So, we will just take this payoff to understand this different strategy. So, let us call this is firm 2, this is firm 1, this is advertised, this is not going for advertised, this is again advertised, this is not going for advertisement. So, when both the firms they get the, when both the firms they are advertising, then firm A get a market share of 50, firm B get a market share of 20. When firm 1 is advertising and firm 2 is not advertising, then firm 1 get 60, firm 2 get 10. When firm 2 is advertising, firm 1 is not advertising, then firm A get 40, firm 2 get 30. When both of them they are not advertising, firm 1 get 55 and firm 2 get 25. Okay. Now, we will understand what is the max min, what is the min max, what is the dominant strategy, or whether they are reaching equilibrium or not. We are assuming that firm 1 and firm 2 both have to be rational. Okay. Now, we will understand this from the firm 2 point of view. Now, if firm 1 advertising, firm 2 will choose a strategy advertising, and here they are getting 20 rather than 10. So, if firm 1 is advertising, firm 2 has two options, either they have to advertise or they have to not advertise. If they are advertising, they are getting 20, if they are not advertising, they are getting 10. So, since 20 is greater than 10, if firm 2 is going for advertising, they are getting a better payoff by advertising. Now, we will analyze the case for firm 2 when firm 1 is not advertising. So, here if firm 1 is not advertising, then it gets 30. If he is advertising, he gets 30, but if he is not advertising, he is getting 25. So, in this case, again 30 is greater than 25. So, what is the strategy, what is the dominant strategy for here? Because whatever firm 1 does, whether advertise or not advertise, always advertising is the best option for firm 2. And since advertise is the best option for firm 2, to advertise is the dominant strategy for firm 2. Okay. Now, how it is a dominant strategy? Because when firm 1 is advertising And firm 2 is also advertising. They are getting a payoff of 20 rather than not advertising. When firm 2 is not advertising, it is getting a payoff of 30 by advertising, which is more than the payoff which is not advertising. So whether firm 1 advertise or not advertise, always the payoff is maximum for firm 2 when they are advertising, like 20 and 30. And that's why to advertise is the dominant strategy for firm 2. Now we'll analyze this from firm 1 perspective. Now suppose firm 2 advertise. What firm 1 will do? If he is advertising, he is getting 50. If he is not advertising, he is getting 40. So if firm 2 is advertising, if firm 1 is advertising, he is getting a better payoff rather than not advertising. And when firm 2 is not advertising and firm 1 is advertising, he is getting a payoff of 60. Firm 2 is not advertising, firm 1 is not advertising, he get a better payoff of 55. Since 60 is greater than 55, and in both these cases, whether firm 2 advertise or not advertise, firm 1 is getting a better payoff in advertising. So when firm 2 is advertising, this is the payoff. When firm 2 is not advertising, this is the payoff when firm 1 is advertising. That's why for firm 1 is also to advertise is the dominant strategy. Dominant strategy for firm 1 also. Because, and how do we interpret this dominant strategy? Irrespective of the whatever the action not taken by the other firm, to advertise is the best possible action or the best strategy by the firm. So in this case, we have dominant strategy for both the firm. What is the dominant strategy for firm 1? To advertise. What is the dominant strategy for firm 2? To advertise. Since both the firms, they have the dominant strategy, we get a equilibrium. And the equilibrium gives us a strategy, that is advertise, this is the payoff, or this is the strategy advertised by both the firms, and this gives us the equilibrium. And since both of them, they have the dominant strategy, this is generally the dominant strategy equilibrium. Then we'll understand the max min and min max strategy taking this specific example. Okay. So to start with, we'll do the max min. Okay. We'll just do the payoff matrix once again to understand this. So advertise, not advertise, advertise, not advertise. So this is firm 2, this is firm 1, so this is 50, 20, 40, 30, 60, 10, 55, 25. Now to understand max min, what is the max min? Players will try to maximize the payoff, the worst payoff, maximize the worst payoff. Now, how this worst payoff will come? That will come from the strategic behavior. Okay. What worst can happen for firm 1? If they advertise, they get 50. If they are not advertising, they get 40. They try to maximize that they should advertise because they are getting a highest payoff. So they, for them, what is the max min strategy? The max min strategy is advertise. Similarly, when the other firms is not advertising, what is the payoff for them? If they are advertising, they get 60. If they are not advertising, they are getting 55. So for them, what is best? Again, if they are advertising, when the farm too is not advertising also. So this is the payoff, that is 50, 40, 60, 55, related to the two kind of strategy, when they are advertising and when they are not advertising. They will try to maximize the value, they are trying to maximize the payoff. So the worst payoff can be 40 if they are not advertising and farm 2 is advertising, and if they are not advertising when farm 2 is not advertising. But since they have to maximize the profit, they will take always the highest payoff, and that's why the maximum strategy for farm 1 is to advertise. Similarly, we will understand for farm 2. Now for farm 2, if the farm 2 is advertising, they get 20, they are not advertising, they are getting 30. Similarly, if they are not advertising, they get 10, and if they are not advertising again, they are getting 25. So what is the maximum? They have to maximize the payoff here. And what is the maximize here? Between this advertising and not advertising, it's 20 and 10. So if they are advertising, they are getting 20. If they are not advertising, they are getting 10. And since they have to maximize the outcome, since they have to maximize the payoff, they will always check this. This is because this 20 is the highest payoff. Similarly, when it comes to farm 2, when farm 1 is not advertising, if they are advertising, they are getting 30. If they are not advertising, they are getting 25. And since 30 is more than 25, they have to maximize the value and they will take 30. So for them, it's always the maximum strategy for farm 2 is also to advertise. Then we'll understand the min-max strategy. And min-max strategy is what? What is the logic for min-max strategy? The player will try to minimize the payoff for the opponents by their own strategy or by their own action. So to put it simply, when farm 1 will decide whether to advertise or not advertise, they will look at which one will give the minimum payoff to the opponents, because that will be chosen by them, and that's why they look for that, how to minimize the payoff of the opponents rather than how to maximize the payoff of their own firm, what generally they look at in the maximum strategy. So min-max strategy, their focus is to minimize the payoff of the rivals or the minimize the payoff of the opponent. So looking, if we'll take now about the min-max, we'll take for farm 1. Now what can be the min-max? For when it comes to farm 2, when they are advertising, what is best to farm 2, they have to also, that is 20. When they are not advertising, what is best for farm 2, that is 30. But if they are not advertising, the other one is getting 25. So now what he will do, farm 1 will try to advertise so that farm 2 is also advertising and they are getting a less payoff rather than not advertising. Because if farm 1 is not advertising, it's getting a highest payoff in both the cases, whether farm 2 advertise or not advertise. But if farm 1 is advertising, whether farm 2 advertise or farm 2 is not advertising, still they get a payoff which is lower than their counterpart, and that's why the min-max strategy for farm 1 has to be to advertise. Similarly, we'll now understand from farm 2 perspective. Now for farm 2, if they are advertising, what is the payoff for farm 1, that is 50, and if they are not advertising, that is 40. When farm 2 is not advertising, the farm one is advertising, they are getting 60, and not advertising, they are getting 55. So since 50 is less than 60 and 40 is less than 55, Firm 2 will feel that it's better to advertise because they are getting a lower payoff whether they are advertising or not advertising. So in that case, the min-max strategy for firm 2 will be also to advertise, because if they are advertising, that gives us the less payoff to the firm 2 rather than not advertising. So this is how we understand this dominant strategy and maximin and min max strategy. Now in this case, in the particular case, if you look at all the strategy, whether it's dominant, whether it maximin or whether it min max, all the strategy there, the to advertise is to is the all the strategy is to advertise for both the firms. This may not happen in all these cases. There may be also whatever the dominant strategy of A, that may not be the dominant strategy of B, or it may happen that there is a dominant strategy for one player but there is no dominant strategy for the other player. So in this case, the possibility is that we will not get a dominant strategy equilibrium where there is a dominant strategy for both the players. Then we will talk about Nash equilibrium. And Nash equilibrium generally propose a strategy for each player such that no player has the incentive to change its action unilaterally, given that the other player follow the proposed action. Because again, equilibrium is a state of balance, equilibrium is a state of rest. Beyond this, there is no incentive for the other firm to go from this equilibrium, because that is the place where they get the maximum profit or maximum positive outcome. So generally, Nash equilibrium proposes strategy for each player so that no player has changed incentive to change its action unilaterally, giving the other players to follow the proposed action. And it is a optimal collective strategy in a game involving two or more player, where no player has anything to gain by changing his or her strategy. So we'll understand this Nash equilibrium taking our previous example. We'll take up the payoff matrix. But it's a case of two firms, that is firm 1 and firm 2, and they have two options to advertise or not advertise, and the final output is in term of the payoff, that is whatever the outcome they are getting. So here we'll add one more new assumption, and the new assumption is here that firm 1 uses a typically expensive advertising agency, and since the advertising agency is doing advertisement for them, that increase their cost of production. And here the firm would try to shift the burden to the consumer in term of increase in the price of the product, so that the company gets lesser market share when it advertises as compared to when it does not advertise. So since they are shifting the burden of the increasing cost to the consumer, it is obvious that the market share will decrease, because when price increases, even if it's a good product, still some amount of the quantity demanded decreases. So that will increase the market, that will increase the price of the product, that will decrease the market share, and company gets a less market share when it advertises compared to what when it doesn't advertise. So accordingly, our payoff matrix will change. And if firm 2 in this case does not advertise, then it is better for firm 1 not to advertise and get a larger share of market. Now here, in one case, firm 1 is doing a expensive advertising and they are passing the cost to the consumer, and second case, and in continuation to that, they are getting a less market share. But if firm 2 doesn't advertise here, then it is better for firm 1 not to advertise and get a larger share of market. So here, what is the best action for firm 2? They are doing the advertising because firm 2 is also doing the advertising. If firm 2 is not doing the advertising, now what is the best choice for firm 1? Best choice for firm 1 is not to advertise, because if they are not advertising, they don't have to spend for a advertising agency. There is no increase in the cost of production, there is no increase in the market price, there is no decrease in the market share. And if there is no decrease in the market share, this is the best possible action or the best possible strategy for firm 1. So we'll continue our discussion on Nash equilibrium taking this specific example. We'll talk about the different types of game, we'll talk about the prisoner's dilemma, and we'll talk about that how this game theory is applied specifically to few of the oligopolist model in our next session.